Welcome back, guys and girls. Today we've got to start off the detail by cleaning the interior. We've got to start with the roof, the headlining. We start with the headlining because, as you can see, there's a lot of spray coming down and it's got to contaminate everything that you clean it below. So I'll do the headlining first. We've got to soak it with, I've got a detailing shampoo here. We've got to soak it with this first. I'm using a sprayer. We'll agitate the solution with a brush. This is my trusty detailing brush, which I've had for 12 years plus, I'd say, and it was used detailing cars for another 10 years before that, so this brush has been around. I'm agitating the headlining here with the brush, bringing the dirt to the surface. You can see it's already looking cleaner already, and then we'll use our wet and dry vac to suck the solution from the headliner. We're actually extracting the solution from the headliner here using the wet vac. Just try and extract as much as you can. Now there's a lot of contours and curves and stuff in the headliner, so you won't be able to get into every part of it. So what I always do is I use a microfiber at the end just to try and suck as much of the solution as possible. Also, another thing to note here is a lot of people don't really like agitating headliners. This particular headliner looks okay, and I've always cleaned headliners like this. A lot of people are a little bit too cautious with cleaning headliners. You don't really need to be. You can bobble them if you go too heavy on them, but it shouldn't really occur. And here is the finished headliner. A lot cleaner, no more greasy marks and stuff. Any marks that you can see are actually in there permanently. You can't actually get them out, just root damage. It actually hasn't come out too bad though, it's pretty good. Now we've got to start on the carpets. I'm using the soap solution here now, the carpet solution. I'm spraying it on fairly liberally first. Let it soak into the carpets because they are very heavily soiled. So once I've sprayed the whole carpet down on the driver's side, I'm going to then start agitating the solution. Then once it's brought to the surface, I'm going to try and extract the solution with my wet and dry vac, and pretty much rinse and repeat until you've got the desired effect that you want to achieve. Now, you have to keep your expectations realistic, especially in a working van like this with such heavily damaged carpets. But what I'm going to do is got to keep on going until I get the result that I'm happy with personally for the actual vehicle.
To the
So I'm coming to the end of what I would deem to be the best possible result for this carpet. So I'm kind of finishing up here, kind of trying to rinse as much of the soap out as I can because I am heavily soaked the area. Extract as much as I can now for making it easier for drying later, and just drying up with a microfiber now to try and absorb as much of the moisture as I possibly can. Now onto the passenger side. I kind of learned a few lessons from doing the driver's side with this particular carpet, so I'm just soaking the area first now with the sprayer on both sides of the carpet. I'm going extremely heavy with the soap solution on the passenger's footwell side, and then I've got to start brushing the carpet, bringing the dirt to the surface and extracting, and again rinsing and repeating until I get the desired effect I'm looking for. See here, I'm just heavily soaking in a couple of areas in particular where there's a bit of heavy staining, rebrushing the area and extracting again. Now we're moving on to the seats. Now there was actually a torrential downpour, and the seats were actually outside, so they did get wet, but they are getting washed anyway, so it's not too bad. Although the foam underneath will be heavily saturated, but to be quite honest with you, I'm going to have to heavily saturate these seats just to extract the years and years of dirt and builder's grime that have been absorbed into them. You can see that they're absolutely filthy. So there's concrete dust on them, there's every kind of mud, everything. They're absolutely soaked and everything, so a good heavy soaking with the soap solution, a very good scrub, and then extract as much as you can, and again rinsing and repeating until they get the desired effect, the best possible outcome for the seats. Extracting here now, trying to extract as much as possible. Go as slow as you can with the extractor. Push into the foam slightly so that it will soak and absorb as much of the moisture out as possible. Yeah.
broken heart, no remedy. But maybe if you stay, I can get away with it. 'Cause you make me love my imperfections, answer all my questions just to show me what's on the other side of inhibition. No apologies, my baby. I tell you though, 'cause I'm feeling so good.
Come back here with a bucket of warm, clean water to try and agitate a bit extra the dirt out of this seat. There was a lot of tide marks in it. So tide marks would be marks left in the seat from years of getting wet and dry and wet and dry. When you're soaking a seat, to clean it, you have to soak the entire seat, otherwise you will experience tide marks. So when you're extracting, extract in a nice clean manner, don't miss any areas, and extract as much as you can, which will prevent tide marks. That's one seat finished. Now moving on to the next seat. This is the driver's seat, and it's actually the worst seat out of the two. So this will take a extra bit of work, let's see. Throughout this detail, I cleaned the seats. There was actually three delivery drivers that came. Now I've got noise cancelling headphones on because of the sound of the extractor, and the extractor is extremely loud. And I'd say these three delivery guys thought it was absolutely mental, because I couldn't hear a word they were saying, and they were probably shouting at me for about 10-15 minutes. To fix the this very sensitive area of the image here, because I know a lot of you might be disappointed, but I know also know a lot of you do not want to see the crack of my arse, so that's why this area of the image is very heavily pixelated. Now that's as good as this seat is gonna get, so I've got to finish up drying it and I've got to move on to cleaning the plastics at the back. I've got to be using my steamer because this particular chair we're looking at here, it's got a dinner tray on the back of it and it's got all sorts of coffee and very soiled ingrained dirt into it, and the only real way to get that out is to use a bit of heat from the steamer. A bit of steam to kind of blow out some of the dirt around the edges, and I'm also cleaning the underside of the seat rails before I put it back into the vehicle. Now here's a shot of the bucket from what we've extracted from the vehicle, the dirty water. It's very 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 dirty, a lot of sand and grit and stuff in it as well. Now we've got to move on to cleaning the couple of pieces of the center console before we put them back in. Again, I'm using the steamer to release a lot of the ingrained dirt on them. Very heavily soiled these couple of pieces. Got to put them back in the car, get the seats put back in, the center console back in, and then we've got to move on to doing the interior plastics. Previous video we got all the plastics degreased and cleaned, so now we can move straight into actually putting a finish on the plastics. Now I've gone for a very very glossy finish on the plastics here because they are so heavily scratched and they're very dry. This hopefully will absorb into the plastic a bit, make it look a bit newer, a bit cleaner, and give a nice finish to the vehicle. So one thing to point out, and it's an important one, is don't miss the inside of the glove box. If you've got a center console, don't miss the inside of your center console. Areas like that, it really affects the overall finish at the end if you miss all those areas. And another important thing just to note is your air vents. do not miss these. This is one area that everybody sees when they get into a vehicle. Dust and debris that are caught in these will ruin your detail at the end. Make sure you get right into the event, clean it, and put your finish on it. If you can't get into the event, these are very difficult to get into. Use a tool, use a little stick or something, anything, or a brush. Apply your finish to it and make sure you cover all of your air vent and get a nice overall finish at the end.
Thank you.
that I have missed is the windows. I'm actually not going to do them yet because I've still got a few more bits to do to the vehicle. I'm just kind of finishing off the interior, plastics and carpets and stuff like that first. And I'll do the windows when the vehicle is finished. Today's video, guys, I'm gonna leave you with a few slow motion shots of the finished interior. Please like, comment and subscribe on the video, and I'll see you later. Peace. Thank you.
Maybe I was wrong, even one wasn't anything.